Okay, welcome to this part 3 video on forex patterns. In this one we'll be looking at the head and shoulders pattern. Okay, so this pattern really forms like the human body, you know, but the upper part, the head, and then the two shoulders. So yes, awesome. Trust me, when I first heard about this pattern, I'm like, heads and shoulders, what is it, the human form or something like that? But yeah, as crazy as it sounds, really good pattern. So that's what I'll be looking at. And to move on, let's get it in there right now. So this is the head and shoulders pattern, as you can see here. Let me just do this. Okay, okay, boom, boom, boom. Okay, so this is the left shoulder. And then this one is the right shoulder, and this is the head. Okay, so shoulder, head, and shoulder, as you can see right here. Okay, head, one, only one head, and then shoulders. Okay, these there, two shoulders. Okay, so very good pattern. Straight it a lot of times and very profitable, very ionic among all patterns are the same, so not really the same but tradable. Yeah, okay, so how do you trade this pattern? Okay, again, disclaimer, the way the head and shoulders pattern is right now won't come out clearly, okay, as in most of the times, most of the patterns won't be like seen clearly. Okay, they're going to be like spikes and stuff like that. It won't be as a good picture, but you have to develop the skill to notice that. Okay, so yeah, this is the head and shoulders pattern. Okay, so how do you trade it? Okay, so whenever you see the head and shoulders pattern, of course it's always going to start with a remarkable uptrend. Okay, something that's going to be just goes up for dynamic purpose. I don't know what it is, due to anything like that, any disasters or anything like that. So when this occurs, we expect it to get this thing form, this one, the left shoulder, and then it's going to be a head. Okay, you'll see something like this. All right, that will be the head, and then you'll find then this. Okay, so why you want to keep your eye now to spot this pattern when it's forming is here, when this occurs. Okay, here. All right, when this happens, when the bounce back happens here, this strong resistance. Okay, when it bounces back on this strong resistance point, so this is why now you start keeping your eye that it's forming a head and shoulders pattern. Okay, so when it occurs, when you see, okay, it's going down, all right, then you can know that it's a head and shoulders pattern. Okay, so then how, which direction, most of the times, if it's a legit OS original pattern, okay, it goes down. Okay, it goes downwards. So let's just go like palm, there, the left shoulder and the right, and then usually it goes down. Okay, same direction from where it started from, and that's what you'll be looking for. So yeah, so you want to look for this occurs. Okay, but you do not want to enter or take a sale right there and then. Okay, it depends on how you make your entries and exit or stuff like that, your technical analysis. But what mostly I do is wait for a breakout to happen and then wait like for a signal candlestick, maybe like the three soldiers. If you know that, yeah, it's good. It's good that she's very important that you know candlesticks. Okay, so most of the times you wait for the three soldiers and then get some confirmation. Or if you want, you can use a simple moving average. Yeah, it depends with the ones you're using. Most of the times they use 200 moving average, which is very good. So when a breakout occurs, okay, when this occurs, let's say three candlestick pattern happen. Okay, so if you don't know what a three soldier candlestick pattern is this. Okay, when this happens, when you see candlestick like one green and then the other one above that one, and then the other one above that one, this is a three soldier pattern candlestick. And then same ones when it's in the downside three. All right, yeah, very good. All right, so when that occurs, you wait for that, And then what I want to do, okay, it depends with how you do it, right? Most of the times there will pullbacks, but some other times there are no pullbacks, so you might miss out, okay? So it depends on how you do that. So let's say we just enter the trade straight from, okay, like now, no pullback across. Just say, okay, I'm entering right here. So what you want to do is enter right about here. You enter your trade here, right? And then where you want to put your stop loss is right here, right above that strong support, which will become our resistance point. So you want to put your TP right here, okay? Your stop loss, sorry, your stop loss, and put your stop loss right about there, all right? And let's say now, where do you take the profit? Okay, now let's say you waited for the pullback. Okay, wait, okay, let's just do this one first. Okay, so after that, so then where do you put your take profit? Okay, so you measure this distance again. Same thing as you would, I think, trade the symmetrical, I mean, the triangle pattern. If you haven't seen the video of that link there, you'll see it. You can go watch it. That's the part one of that. So I'm not sure about that. Okay, so you measure this distance, and then this distance is where you can put your take profit. So most of the times it's going to go to this distance. Okay, so about here, can I hit there? All right, so that's the first thing how you can trade this one. And now let's say maybe you waited for the pullback to occur, right? Okay. So let's say you waited for the pullback to occur. Okay. The market goes, has a pullback of this. Boom, right there. So you decide to enter there. So where do you put your stop loss? Okay. Again, enter there. So if I was here, I wouldn't want to stay in this trend if the market breaks this strong support. Okay. If the market breaks this strong support, I wouldn't want to be in it. All right. That means it's a false breakout, or maybe it's just a different pattern or just a false signal. So what I want is just put my stop loss right above here. Okay. Yeah, because sometimes it can break and then go down. You don't want to put it too tight again, too long. No, not that. So you put it there, and then you enter your trade right there. Okay, and then it goes down, and then boom. You wait patiently, and then you take your profit right over there. So this is how you trade. This is how you trade the head and shoulders pattern, and most of the time it's just exactly the way I've shown you right now. But again, disclaimer, the way it shows up here, it doesn't show up like clearly the way it is right now. Okay, in the market it's really very bearish, or I can say spike. It's not neat, okay? It's not clean, but you have to get used to that. And yeah, I have something here on the screen. Yeah, it's a forex chart. You can just pause the video and try to spot the head and shoulders pattern. Yeah, okay, but for the sake of time, we can just go ahead and roll it. So the first thing that I like to do, as you can see here, okay, I'm just doing this from here. We can, okay, to make it easier, just draw a support first. Okay, we'll draw this support about somewhere about here. Okay, that's the first support. Okay, and then we're gonna define, just try to define where it hits the left shoulder is. So as you can see here, as you can see, the momentum here was going up and then upside, and then here down, when it'll be down here, as you can see that, and then went up here and then went down. Okay, so I'm just trying to give you some clues of how I define this pattern. So go like that, okay, and then down. Okay, as you can see here, this is the shoulder, left shoulder. This is the head. So again, this one here, this is the left shoulder right there. This is the head. This is the right shoulder. So after the pattern find it, so what do you do? As we discussed earlier on, is that if you want to take your entry point, if let's say you took your entry point over here before the pullback occurred, as you can see here, let's say you took there, right? You put your entry point there, and then as I said last time, that you would want to make sure your stop loss is above this strong support, okay? Yeah, which become now a resistance right there. See that? So as even if the market comes here, it doesn't take you out. As you see, immediately when it hits there, it goes down. So that's what you want to do. And let's say you waited for the pullback, right? Let's say you waited for the pullback to occur. Where would you want to put your stop loss? Okay. So again, let's say you waited for the pullback and the pullback occurred as you expected it to be. Let's say you took your entry point right here, right? So you'll want to find a strong point where it's not likely to, what can I say, take you out, but again, likely that when it goes that likely that when it doesn't go your way, you're likely to take a loss and to risk management, yeah, so like that. So it measures this and this one looks like this one looks like a strong support. So you can put your stop loss right over there. Then you enter your trade right here. Okay. Enter your trade here. All right. And then this will be your stop loss, right? So that when the market cross over this one, we're out of the trade. We don't want to be in a trend which isn't there. Okay, we don't want to be in a trade that is that we didn't expect it to be. So yeah, risk management and preserving your capital is really the first thing that you have to take into key. So when that happens, you take there and then take your profits again, as we discussed. You measure this distance from here where the trend started from, right there. Okay. So from this distance, you can put your take profit right about, as you can see there, straight there. Okay. So you can put your TP here. Your TP there. All right. This is where you can put your take profit. And then, yeah, goes down, hits your take profit, good trade, amazing, we take a profit. Okay, so this was it for today. Yeah, and you can do, I recommend that you go back test it, yeah, and just try to get comfortable with it and try to get the keys to spot patterns, because sometimes it can be very difficult. So yeah, I recommend you do that. You go back test, you try out the strategy and stuff that can fit in you. This is really profitable. So I've reached the end of the video, and if you like to give it a thumbs up, comment down below, subscribe to the channel and press the notification bar to get notified when I upload new videos, and I will see you in the next video.